No, but this is Windows 10 21H2 cleverly done to mimic the look and feel of Windows Server 2003. Or you can use this as an alternative server OS, I guess. Hi everyone, I'm Everything Windows and this is Vibranium Server 2003. Jumping to the setup, the boot screen uses Windows 10 and it uses Panda 2K as its setup program to utilize classic look with modern backend. After that, the setup finishes and we are ready to go to the desktop. Rebooting the OS after VMware Tools has been installed, the logon screen is using the classic variant and it's not just a gimmick, it's actually working, even though I don't set the password for this VM yet. And here we are on the desktop. Even though we aren't greeted by manage your server like in Windows Server 2003, we are greeted with the classic theme set by default with these XV icons as cherries on the top. But not all these icons are in Server 2003, as the original Server 2003 only has security configuration wizard and recycled as icons on the desktop. Other than that, it's just addition from the mod maker. Well, at least the icon changed to Windows XP, so I don't decline that. Checking out the security configuration wizard to see if it's functional and not decorative. It actually works. Thanks to the classic help, you can navigate through all helps and guides to set up your server's security configuration. Although I doubt the guides will help you completely, as this is designed for Windows Server 2003. Nonetheless, it's a good functional decoration. Looking at the taskbar, there's nothing big expected for this, as you can easily achieve the look with retro bar. But what I'm invested in is either this OS uses XP style start menu or just classic start menu. And turns out it is using the classic start menu. There's a but. So far, I think, apart from OpenShell, there's not much free customization tool that replicates the look of XP's style start menu. Let me know if you know any alternative in the comments down below. Even if the start menu isn't similar, the programs listed are already similar enough to me. Moving to Windows Explorer, apart from the copy icon being different, the application is strikingly accurate. Starting with the details pane used as a default view down to the command bar and the Windows flag present inside. Now that's what I call a very good recreation. But I don't stop there as I briefly check out the menu strip above. Although most of them do work, the tools option is blank and any items inside the help option is dummy, including the help and support center and about Windows, unfortunately. But hey, you can customize the view mode in the Explorer. If you want the tile view as it was, go ahead. If you want extra large view for your pops to use, go ahead, I'm not stopping. But we have to look at the C drive first. I don't know why the C drive triggers the music icon at the bottom right corner of the screen. Like really, I don't know, but I assume it's just a bug. And in here, we have to address the view mode situation. When we choose either extra large or large, the low color network place icon exists behind every single icon. Is this a bug or a poor quick left in? I'll let the creator decide what's the issue here. So I recommend you to stay in any view but extra large and large. Alright. For directory navigation, it works just fine. Well, the sorting order is inaccurate as Windows Server 2003 has a different order which consists of name, size, type, date modified, and attributes, rather than this one that consists of name, date modified, type, and size, which I think is the one set by default on Windows 10. You can set several folders to use accurate order, but the Windows 10 order will always be the default throughout all directories. Next, control panel. Opening it from the start menu, you'll get the perfect remake with the correct view, name, and comment. Well, the portable media device's applet is missing, but that's okay. Looking at most applets in here, the add hardware points towards device manager. Add remove hardware goes to the modern programs applet. Automatic updates does nothing. Photo option has minor differences to what's in Windows 10. Game controllers doesn't allow you to add any controller whatsoever. Internet properties has one of its tabs blank. Licensing, which you can see on the screen right now. Regional option leaves out the Windows 10 version as seen in a comparison. This applies to the sound tablet too. Stored usernames and password, which I actually don't expect to work correctly. And lastly, the taskbar and start menu. Now, here's the question. How can the creator make the special view of control panel in here? If you look at the address bar, it's actually a folder inside the C drive, and it uses a special view for this exact folder. And if this control panel isn't real, then where's the real one? By running run dialog to open control.exe, the real control panel is there with the category view, even though seeing Windows XP icons is quite abnormal. Since this is the original control panel, you can access the large icons view that shows you several unlisted applets. A cheeky way to do it, eh? I told you earlier in the video that it is Windows 10, despite the WinVerse showing Windows Server 2003 along with its build number. To prove you that it is Windows 10, check out this system information. Well, the system properties on the other side identifies as Windows Server 2003. This customization is done thanks to Mr. Amayosken. Yes, you heard that right. The same dude who made Project Memphis and many others. If you ever want to see me check out more Windows mods, beta builds and experiments, be sure to join the Discord server as well as making posts on the newly created Everything Windows YouTube community. Back to the OS. Opening the display properties from the context menu, there is a glitch in the themes tab. This can be fixed by choosing it again in the combo box, but it will display Windows 7 window layout for some reason. Alright. The desktop background here is the same as in Windows XP, except for the tiled background, which is lacking in here. Screensaver only has three, which is None, Marquee, or just the Windows Server 2003 logo. What about the appearance? Well, anyway, the sound scheme only has a startup sound, which is accurate. Running several system applications, as you already guessed, Internet Explorer is Firefox 115 customized to look like it. And since this is a modern web browser, you can navigate through YouTube, my YouTube channel, which hasn't reached 11,000 subscribers yet. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Windows Media Player is version 10, like the real version 10, with the ability to enjoy media from your computer with a generated duplicate done completely legal. And you already know about the core Unity system applications like Calculator, Notepad, WordPad, and Paint. You already know the gist of it. It's the classic version. Now, for pre-installed applications, we got Character Map, Phone Dialer, Command Prompt, Task Manager, and Sound Recorder. Surprisingly, System Restore is maintained in here, even though Server 2003 doesn't have that by default. Well, the System Restore here is the version found on Windows 10 anyway. Furthermore, you can view any image using Windows Picture and Fax Viewer, although strangely enough, it isn't set by default. But you can still view the image. And there it is, my Windows CD collection from XP to Windows 7. If any of you fancy the old school style of reaching out your friends and family, you can choose Outlook Express, if you know how to set it up and use it. Remote desktop connection has the accurate banner inside the program. And lastly, Sync Center. Oh yeah, I forgot one thing. MS Config does have its NT5.x look and feel like in Windows XP or Server 2003, but it misses the boot.ini tab,
which is really crucial since that's the tab where you choose to boot in SafeMode or not, customize multi-boot configuration, and many more.
Duh! Ease of access applications are true to the origin, unlike most Windows 10 mods, which are basically ignoring these programs. Magnifier and on-screen keyboard reverted back to its previous version. Nice detail. Okay. Next, for multitasking and utilization feature, the old tab interface is greatly done to use the traditional version, and the security option known as Control-Alt-Delete is using the server version, and it's functional, thank goodness. Okay, ever feel lost in the operating system? Well, fret not, because help and support are here to help. Why is it blank? And it's dummy. Why? Oh gosh, I don't have any help, right? Thank you very much. Remember that this is based on Windows 10? Yeah, because I want to show you several Windows 10 features left in here by accident or by nature. Backup and restore, which is already crucial. PowerShell is likely because it's PowerShell. Windows 10 settings for any configuration unable to be done in the Windows Server 2003 versions. Windows 10 start menu can be accessed by using Shift and Windows key. Task view and virtual desktop is here to help you manage your multitasking. Sniffing tool? Yeah, using Windows Shift as shortcut. Although I can't find the saved screenshot anywhere within the OS. Windows 10 Action Center is present, as well as Windows Security. Oh yeah, if you fancy typing with advanced management, you can use the Windows and full stop shortcut to open emoji panel, and Windows and V shortcut to open clipboard history, which is very useful for me to organize copied content on the go. But not all features from future Windows version are present in here. Arrow snap, arrow peak, and arrow shake are nowhere to be seen. Search essentially does nothing, even from Windows Explorer. Configure your server and manage your server can't be open. An address book is changed to Windows contacts. The very last thing, the shutdown dialog is accurate, even though you can just press OK anyway, unlike Windows Server 2003 that requires you to enter the reason. All in all, this is a solid mod from Mr. Amayosken. I've tried the first known mod from him, which is Windows 10 to 7 version 22H2 back in 2023, and I'm happy to see the evolution of the modding skill he has. You can experience this mod by downloading and testing in the virtual machine, or if you are good enough, you can mod it as if the server OS is actually your main operating system.